Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitza Shulchan Aruch in the laws of the night of Yom Kippur. And he writes, Leil Yom HaKippurim v'yoyma, on the night of Yom Kippur and during the daytime. Oyimrim Baruch Shem Kevoy Malchuso Leolam Vayed B'kol Ram. We know we say Shema Yisrael Hashem Elokeinu Hashem Echad. And throughout the year, we always say quietly, Baruch Shem Kevoy Malchuso Leolam Vayed. Blessed is His name. Is the name of His glorious kingdom for all of eternity, because this is a prayer that is reserved for the malachim, for the angels. However, on Yom Kippur, we ourselves are like the malachim, Asharis, we're like the angels, and therefore we have a right to say this out loud as well. There are people who stand on their feet, b'chol seder tefilas arvis, the entire prayers of the evening, b'chol hayom, and the entire day as well. They stand from beginning till the very end. We're like malachim, again, like we said, we're like angels over here, and therefore we want to emulate them. However, if a person feels weak, they can lean on something. The reason that we stand, like I just said, is because we want to emulate the malachim, the angels. And the angels don't sit, so why should we sit? We have to be angelic on the day of Yom Kippur. Now, of course, it should be noted, as the Shah Tzion says, that if a person is going to get exhausted from standing all day long, and he might end up coming to fall asleep during the prayers, or he's going to end up losing his concentration, so then certainly he would be allowed to sit. And since that angels are always referenced in the male form in Chazal and in our Psukim, not in the feminine form, therefore women have no obligation to stand throughout Yom Kippur. Misha Omid Pam. Acha, someone who stood 1 year on Yom Kippur. Al das lases can call Yom of that he had intention. I want to do this every Yom Kippur. I always want to stand up. And afterwards he decides, you know, it's too much for me to stand the entire time. He needs to have an annulment of the vows because it's like he made a vow over here to stand. Fine. And the last halacha in this chapter is, there are people who have the custom to stay up the whole night and stay in the shul. And they say songs and praises to HaKadosh Baruch Hu all night long. If they have to fall asleep, they have to at least distance themselves away from the Aron Kodesh, the Ark, not a cover for the Ark to be lying and sleeping in front of it. However, the Chazan, the one who's leading the davening, he should not stay up all night. Because by staying up all night, they'll be exhausted and they'll end up losing their voices. Before a person goes to sleep, they should say the first four kapitulach, the first four tehillims that are in the book of Psalms. They should say the first four. Because these first four help to save a person from having a seminal emission on the night of Yom Kippur, which is not a very good thing. Not a good thing to have one. Ki yesh bem shin vav tevas. There's 306 words altogether in those first four tehillim. V'dalad mizmorim. Plus you have the four tehillims themselves. So you have 306 plus four. Oyel l'shin vav. It comes out to be 310. What is 310? Kiminyan carry. That's the same numerical value as carry, which means a seminal discharge. So therefore, what are we trying to say over here? We're trying to say that I'm saying these tehillim in order to prevent myself from having a seminal discharge. Furthermore, says the Kitzur, that the beginning and the end of the four Psalms, if you count the letters over there, you have 126. Then you have the four mizmorim plus an additional one, which is part of this gematria, the way that it works, is going to be 5. That means 126 plus 5, that's 131. B'yachar oylu kuf lamin aleph, it goes to 131. Kaminyan Samael. Samael is a evil force in the world, an angel that's a evil force. V'yichav in the salkum me'olav, and your intention is, I want to get rid of him. V'tayv shalo yis'ate, if a person should not wrap themselves up too well on the night of Yom Kippur, b'karim, k'sasayz, and mechamimin, not with a lot of covers or pillows to warm his body. At least he shouldn't cover his feet. Because once again, the kids are saying, being too hot at night could bring about a seminal emission, and a person does not want to have an emission on the night of Yom Kippur. Okay. Have a wonderful day, a wonderful Shabbat Shuvah. We will continue Bez Hashem next week.